I hereby confer upon you the honorary degree of Ph.D.
Ph.D.?
That's Doctor of Thinkology.
Hi, and welcome back to my devlog for Steal from Gods, a first-person stealth game made in Unity. It's been a while since my last devlog, but it's been a productive time, and I got a lot done. I could have kept building things for my game, but I finally decided to stop where I was so I can write a devlog and figure out my next steps. So let's get started. First thing I did was I gave the enemies a brain, finally. I love AI programming and really wanted to get the AI right, but I was struggling over which AI framework to use, finite state machines or behavior trees. I started off building a modular finite state machine, but it started getting too complicated. I switched to a behavior tree, but I really struggled with interrupts and prioritizing behavior between different situations. Then I read some papers and watched this GDC talk.
You don't have to pick one. You can pick multiple. You know? Choose. What I've kind of found to be an elegant approach to solving this problem, for me at least, is something I like to call a hierarchical finite state machine behavior tree hybrid, or Huffersum, but to her for short. Rolls off the tongue.
And I decided to combine finite state machines and behavior trees. I developed a finite state machine system with nested behavior trees, leveraging the graph node tutorials from the QE coder. Each enemy has a set of states they can be in. Each state has entry actions, exit actions, transition conditions, and a behavior tree. Every AI loop, the enemy AI checks to see if any transaction conditions have been met. If so, they run a series of exit actions, then enter a new state. If not, they execute their behavior tree, going through the tree nodes as usual. This modular system will also let me create dynamic environmental actions. For instance, if an enemy walks into a tavern or something, I can easily have the enemy enter a new state, tavern, with a behavior tree for sitting and drinking, and then let them return to their previous state afterwards. Next up, I gave my AI some eyes and ears. Since I'm building a stealth game, I wanted the enemy's detection to feel both realistic and fair. The player should be able to intuitively understand how visible or noisy their character is. In my last mini devlog, I talked about building a system to measure the player's visibility. I've since upgraded the system by creating a white sphere, invisible to the player, that follows the player character around. The shadow detection camera looks at the sphere to measure how dark or light the player's current location is. I also moved all the expensive computation for measuring lightness to the GPU, using a compute shader, which wasn't too hard to figure out once I got used to the very weird syntax. Anyway, I based the enemy's sight detection system off an open source asset, Devdog's Line of Sight Pro, or LOS Pro, with some modifications of my own. The detection system first checks to see if the player is in range and in the enemy's field of vision. Each enemy has three field of views with different ranges, based on roughly on how humans see. The enemies can see further right in front of them, less far to the sides, and not very far at all if the player's in their peripheral vision. When the player is in these view cones, the enemy ray casts to the three points along the player's body. If two are more in line of sight and not blocked by anything, the enemy starts detecting the player. This lets players, for instance, crouch and look out behind crates without getting spotted. Once the enemy starts detecting the player, it takes another second or two for them to recognize that they're seeing a player. If the player manages to escape before then, the guards will be alerted and start investigating, but if they can't find anything, they'll just give up and go back to their normal state, be it patrolling or hanging out. If 2 seconds pass and the player hasn't gotten out of range or gone into hiding, however, the guards will have successfully detected the player. Enemy noise detection works a bit differently. First, something, either a player's footstep or a thrown item, hits a collider. This generates a sphere collider that expands outwards at the speed of sound. If the sphere's collider touches an enemy, the AI calculates a path, which simulates how sound propagates through empty spaces and is muffled by walls, or casts a raycast to the player. If the path or raycast is under a certain threshold, the enemy will have heard the sound. And last but not least, enemies will obviously know when they've been hit by something, either a throwing knife or a bucket. If they can't see the player, they will pick a random point along the direction of the attack and start searching. For enemy AI, just like in real life, vision is prioritized over listening. If an enemy is chasing after a player they can see, they'll ignore any distracting noises. But if they're searching for someone, or just wandering around, and they hear a noise, they'll go investigate, which can be used to distract guards. So, great, the enemies have eyes and ears and brains. But what do they do with these? In the patrol state, an enemy just goes between various waypoints. Easy. In the investigate state, trigger when the enemy has detected something, but not completely seen the player, or maybe just heard something. The enemy will go to the suspicious location to investigate, and generate a small grid of places nearby to search. Once the timer expires, they'll give up on their search and return to their default state. In combat, trigger when the enemy can see the player, they chase after the player and, once inside the combat range, start attacking. The player can run away and hide, and the enemy will search the player's last known location. Or the player can try to block the enemy attacks and fight back. Right now, the number of states in the behavior trees themselves are quite limited, but it is already fun to attack and sneak by enemies. I'm planning to scale up the enemy complexity quite a bit, with ranged attacks, the ability to detect environmental changes such as corpses or open doors, and different levels of suspicion, impacting how the enemy reacts to strange noises. I've got a few minor touch-ups to do next, like add dialogue and barks to signal to the player what state the enemy is in, as well as some accessibility options for the hearing impaired. But I'm pretty happy with the progress I've made so far. The bones of a game are there, and now I can start working towards having a playable prototype. Next up, working on animations, models, shaders, and audio to make my game look and sound good, or at least, not terrible. Thanks for tuning in, and see you next time. If you enjoyed this, leave a like. If you have a better way to design a AI framework, leave a comment in the comment section. And if you want to see more, subscribe to my channel and follow me on Twitter. Bye.